name is Shelby Simpson, and so just a little bit about me. I just came back from my freshman year at BYU. I was on the ballroom team, which was lots of fun, and my major is exercise and wellness. So I got my call back in January, and I thought for sure either I would go somewhere French speaking, because I took 3 years of French in high school, or somewhere in Italy, because a lot of my family is there. But I opened up my call, and I was called to the Peruchi Bio Mission on May 14th, speaking Spanish, and reported to the Peru MTC. And immediately I knew that that's where I was supposed to be. But what actually happened, so since the whole corona thing, I've been blessed with the opportunity to do the MTC with my grandma up in St. George, and I'm super excited to have that experience with her. I haven't wanted to do it with anybody else. Then after that, I don't really know what's going to happen, but I'll probably get reassigned somewhere for a while and then go serve in Chile as soon as possible. So Bishop asked me to talk a little bit about personal revelation and about my process for deciding and preparing to serve a full-time mission. So basically, personal revelation is communication from God to his children, often through the Holy Ghost. So I personally think that we're so blessed to have the opportunity and the ability to hear from God, just as we're able to talk to him. So we can ask him a question and then he'll give us an answer, so long as we pray for guidance, are reverent and humble, keep the commandments, partake of the sacrament, study the scriptures every day, and take our time to ponder. So growing up, I never wanted to go on a mission, so I had three big reasons. So number one, I had like big plans, like I wanted to go to BYU and dance and get married super young and have kids super young. But a mission was just not in those plans. And then number two, Orange County has kind of spoiled me. I did not want to risk the chance of going to a third world country. I didn't want to live like uncomfortably, and I didn't want to eat different food. And then the third one, which was the biggest reason, I felt weird about sharing the gospel. So I had a lot of non-member friends in high school, and they knew I was a member and knew I had certain standards, but I never explained why or even tried explaining like any part of the gospel to them, because I felt like super awkward. So it's like, well, if I had no experience talking to my friends about the gospel, like why would I share it with like random strangers in like a different place? Then junior senior year came around and I felt like I should get my patriarch a blessing. The first thing the patriarch asked me was if I was planning to serve a mission, and I was like, oh my goodness, no, like that is not for me. But then like the second thing he said in my blessing was, I bless you, dear Shelby, that at the appropriate time, you will be called to serve a full-time mission for the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, even by a living prophet of God. And when he said that, I was like, oh sweet, like I can go with my husband when we're old, like that would be so much fun. And then at the end of his little paragraph, it said that the experiences that I would have as a missionary would help me be a better mother and a better wife. And I was like, well, shoot, that means I have to go at 19. So I came home and I was like, so I guess I'm going on a mission. The idea was up in the air for a while and I didn't like to talk about it because I thought that if I just didn't talk about it, then it would just go away. So I continued to just like kind of ignore what was said in my patriarchal blessing. And fast forward to the first semester at BYU, I took teachings and doctrines of the Book of Mormon. And one day we talked about personal revelation, and my professor shared two quotes. So the first one was by Richard G. Scott saying, each of us must stay in condition to respond to inspiration and the promptings of the Holy Ghost. The Lord has a way of pouring pure intelligence into our minds to prompt us, guide us, to teach us, and to warn us. Each son and daughter of God can know the things that they need to know instantly. And the second quote was by Boy K. Packer, and it says, the Spirit does not get our attention by shouting or shaking us with a heavy hand. Rather, it whispers. It caresses so gently that if we're preoccupied, we may not feel it at all. He He then challenged us to always be ready to receive revelation because it comes at the most unexpected times. So he gave us an example. He said, so when you're walking to classes or driving places, don't listen to music, don't go on your phone. Just kind of like have like a little prayer in your heart and a question in your mind, and just like live in the moment and just like wait for the answer to come to you. Then he also suggested that we take about 10 minutes a day for like meditation and just like really like thinking about our questions and like thinking about our answers and like just like inviting the spirit and like waiting for an answer to come. So I tried my best to follow through with this to see if a mission really was right for me, because I didn't want to like go on a mission and then have people ask like, oh, like why did you go? And then have me be like, oh, well, it said so in my picture of the blessing, so I had to. So I wanted like a for sure answer. So I did this for weeks. I didn't hear anything. I was getting kind of frustrated because it had been a while and I was like, can you please just like give me a yes or no? It's not that hard. But I kept it going. General conference came around and me and my roommate were watching, and I was hoping that I would get my answer somewhere here. I didn't until after the Sunday session. So as soon as it was over, I looked at my roommate and I was like, Amanda, you need to give me the bishop's number. Like, I need to text him and I need to make an appointment. So I made an appointment, and like literally all I could talk about up until January was how excited I was to start my mission papers and to turn them in and to get my call. And then as soon as I got my call, all I could do was watch videos about Chief Bio or look up interesting facts or like read people's blogs about their mission experience. And I was so stoked. And I'd fallen in love with the people and the place already, and I hadn't even been there. Other things I did to help prepare me for a mission. So I took mission prep the following semester, and that actually helped a lot. I read my scriptures every day, and I tried going to the temple as much as possible. And I even like took 10 minutes of my day to learn Spanish. Then this whole coronavirus thing happened, and missionaries started to get sent home. And I was super worried that I might not be able to go to the place that I was specifically called to. So after that, prospective missionaries were given the decision to either delay the mission 10 to 12 months or keep going with the process and have a possible temporary reassignment. So this stressed me out like a lot. So I was like, why is this happening? Like, I'm so excited to go and like I never wanted to go before. And then like all of a sudden like it kind of just like got taken away. So I prayed a little and I felt inspired to read my page of the blessing again. And in the same paragraph about my mission, it says, trust in the call and honor the Lord's timetable for extending the sacred call to serve. So I knew I had to keep going with the process and keep pushing forward, even though like it wasn't exactly what I was planning. So through this experience, I learned so much more about the importance of faith, patience, and personal revelation. And the Lord's timing is just like not our timing. So I just want to close with a quick scripture and my testimony. The scripture is Matthew 7:7-8. Ask and it shall be given to you, seek and you shall find, knock and it shall be opened unto you. For everyone that asketh receiveth, and he that seeketh findeth, and to him that knocketh it shall be opened. Heavenly Father is so willing to give us answers and direction in our life. All we have to do is ask. It's so easy. And we just need to be ready to receive our answer because it could come at any time. And so I feel so blessed that I have this opportunity to become closer to my Savior and Heavenly Father, even if it wasn't exactly what I was expecting. I felt so much light and love from this gospel, and I'm so excited to share that with the people wherever I end up going. So I know even if my mission isn't exactly what I was expecting, it will be the best 18 months ever, and I'm so stoked. And I can't wait to start the MTC next week. greatest things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.